In this video, we'll continue exploring and customizing the Maya layout, starting with shelves. In addition to menus, Maya contains icons on shelves. Similar to the shelf in Softimage, which was essentially introduced to accommodate Maya users. These icons are grouped in a similar way to the menus on the menu bar and contain the most common commands from there. For example, clicking the Render Current Frame icon on the rendering shelf is the same as choosing the Render Current Frame command on the menu bar. To save a bit of space, you can click the arrow here to open the shelf menu and turn off shelf tabs to hide them. Then click this box above and select a shelf from the menu. The real power of shelves is that you can create your own custom shelf so that your most commonly used tools, scripts, and plugins are close at hand. Open the shelf menu and choose New Shelf, then give it a name. It becomes the current shelf that's displayed. Just to note that special characters such as $, question mark, and spaces are not allowed in the shelf name. You can then populate the shelf with tools and commands. For example, open a menu and press Ctrl plus Shift and click the command you want to add, such as many of your favorite editors. To change the order of the icons on the shelf, middle-click and drag them. To delete an icon, middle-click and drag it to the trash can at the right end of the shelf, or right-click on it and choose Delete. Shelves are saved as MEL files in the Maya Prefs Shelves folder, so it's easy to copy a custom shelf file to share with others. For example, your team can all use the same plugins or scripts if they share a custom shelf. For more information on creating custom shelves, especially how to include scripts on them, see the video Working with Shelves on the Maya Learning Channel. If you don't want to use shelves at all, or other panels in the layout, you can hide them by toggling items on the UI Elements list on the Display menu. This is pretty much the same as selecting which panels to hide or display from the View Optional Panels menu in Softimage. With a minimalist interface, you can then use hotkeys and marking menus to choose commands, which we'll cover in the next video. You'll notice that there isn't really a single equivalent of Softimage's main command panel, or MCP, in Maya. However, the status line contains some of the same general tools. For example, you have the selection options, the snapping options, construction history options, render options, and the input box where you can transform, select, or rename objects without needing the channel box to be displayed. You can hide or display each of these sections by toggling the little divider bars. Note that the menu set and the sidebar buttons are also part of the status line, so those get hidden too if you hide the status line. The transform tools and some basic selection tools are found on the toolbox on the left, which we'll cover in other videos. Moving down, the time slider in Maya works pretty much the same way as the timeline in Softimage, with the range slider below the time slider and the playback controls on the right. Unlike Softimage, looping is on by default, and you'll notice that the playback speed might be different. You can change the playback speed, looping, and other options for the scene by right-clicking on any of the playback buttons and selecting from the menu. But to set the default behavior of the time slider, click the Animation Preferences icon to open the Preferences window. In the time slider area, you can set all the options as you want, such as the playback start and end, time slider height, looping, and playback speed. One nice little feature is to show grease pencil frames, which gives a visual indication on the timeline of the frames where you've added grease pencil drawings. While you're here, you should set the default frame rate in settings to what you want before you start animating. We'll cover the time slider and animation in more detail in other videos. Similar to Softimage's script line at the bottom of the window is Maya's Mel command line, where you can enter commands and scripts. While you might think that Mel is some guy who runs commands in the background, MEL actually stands for Maya Embedded Language, which is the scripting language that's used throughout Maya. You already saw that the preferences and shelf files are Mel scripts, but everything you do in Maya creates a Mel command, which you can see if you click the Script Editor button in the lower right corner. Just as in Softimage's script editor, you get the history of commands that were executed, and you can create your own scripts here using Mel or Python. To make sure you see all the commands whenever you do anything in Maya, choose History Echo All Commands. Otherwise, you'll just be getting a subset of possible commands. We'll cover scripting in more detail in other videos, but you can take a look at the Creating a Zombie Simulation Using Mel video series on the Maya Learning Channel to see some basic scripting in action. Beside the Mel command line is the Display Command Response, which gives you feedback about the status of a tool, including error messages and warnings. And below the Mel command line is the Helpline, which is similar to the status line in Softimage. It displays short descriptions of tools and menu commands as you move the cursor over them or select them. In the next video, we'll look at the different ways of choosing commands, using tools, and setting attributes in Maya.